Wilton, from the 7th until the 12th century, was a very influential abbey, and then grew in influence even until the dissolution of the monasteries by Henry VIII, when most of them were closed down across the country. And this, an estate of nearly 60,000 acres at the time, was given to William Herbert, who was very close to the king, and who happened to be married to Anne Parr, sister of Henry's last wife. At the turn of the 19th century, at Windsor, James Wyatt, the man of the moment, was putting in wonderful corridors and all sorts. And it was the thing to copy what the royals were doing. And therefore, in 1801, George, the 11th Earl, had James Wyatt come in and create these wonderful corridors, beautiful. And they're pretty much as we see them today.
My sister is Georgiana.
The Wilton House has a progressive floor plan of staterooms. It mirrors the function of the courts, to regulate contact between sovereignty and subjects through a filtering system. Few people ever go beyond the second room, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. First, we'll start in the single cube room. It measures 30 feet long, 30 feet wide, and 30 feet high, making it a perfect cube. This room is ornate and lavish and contains Roman-inspired grotesques, with 26 paintings in the dado. From there, we move into the double cube room. The measurements are both 30 feet wide and 30 feet high, just like the single cube room. However, the double cube room is more than 30 feet long. It's 60, twice the length. Here are wall-to-wall portraits by Van Dyck in his studio, including his largest piece, Family, which is 17 feet wide. These two spectacular rooms are where Lord Pembroke and the court would meet and dine with the king. Beyond these rooms is an anteroom, a waiting room of sorts, and past that is where the king would sleep and dress. But only the most privileged courtiers and trusted servants could access him there.